In this last part, we'll be writing a MEL script which takes the user's current selection of NURBS curves and converts them into a single object whose channels can be used to control other objects in the scene. This way, we can easily rotate our controllers in the scene without having to select the specific groups individually in the outliner. To follow along, feel free to download the zip file in the description section of this movie and open this scene. Start by entering the left orthographic view. Turn on grid snapping and create a three-point arc. Move the curve over next to the dish. Select Edit, Duplicate Special to create a copy of the curve. Rotate the copy by 90 degrees along the y-axis. Next, create a circle in the scene and place it on top of the curves. Repeat the same process to fit a smaller circle at the base of the curves. In the outliner, we now have four curves which we can select individually. If we enable Display Shapes, we can expand these curves to reveal the hierarchy of transform nodes and shape nodes, which we had described in the previous movie. To make these curves part of a single object, our goal is to use MEL to nest to the shape nodes under one common transform node. Use a pair of curly brackets to define a local scope and access the user's current selection with the ls command. We won't be concerned with the selection order here, so we can use the SL flag instead of the OS flag. Use the filter expand command with a selection mask of 9 to filter the selection array for NURBS curves. If the user hasn't selected any NURBS curves, we'll add the following if statement to provide appropriate feedback. Create an empty transform node with the create node command. Use the end flag to set the node's name to controller. Maya replaces the pound symbol with an incrementing number to ensure the name stays unique. Next, iterate over each selected curve transform node. Call XForm with the CP flag on the curve transform to center its pivot. This will make rotating the end result more consistent. Call MakeIdentity to freeze the current curve's transforms and to bake its control points at their current positions. This call to MakeIdentity is the same as selecting Modify Freeze Transformations on the curve. Use the pick walk command with the direction flag set to down to access the shape node nested below the given transform. The result is an array, but we're only interested in the first element. Call the parent command to set the shape node as a child of the target transform node. The S flag makes the parent command act on shape nodes. The add flag ensures the shape node is not removed from its current parent. This is equivalent to instancing the shape node under a new transform. This approach avoids any destructive action in our scene. Add a call to the hide command to make the initial curve transform invisible in the viewport. Outside the for loop, call XForm with the CP flag to center the target transform's pivot. Call the delete command with the CH flag to delete the target transform's construction history. Finally, select the resulting transform node. To test our script, select the curves in the scene and press Run. In the outliner, we now have a new controller node which we can select with any one of its curves in the viewport. In the channel box, lock the translation channels as well as Rotate Y and Rotate Z. The controller now only rotates around its local X axis. Let's open the node editor to connect the X rotation attribute to the appropriate attribute in the hierarchy. Select the controller and add it to the workspace. You can remove the shape nodes that appear along with it. Next, expand the satellite dish hierarchy and add the dish group node to the workspace. Expand both nodes and their respective rotate attribute groups. Click and drag to directly connect the controller's rotate X output to the dish group's rotate X input. Now, the controller's rotation drives the dish group rotation around the X axis. We could have also used the connect ATTR command to make this connection. Let's save our current script to our shelf as NCont, short for NURBS controller. We can also save it to our file system as nurbscontroller.mel. Now that we have our shelf script made, we can create a new controller for the dish's Y rotation. Select the trapeze model and enter edge mode. You may want to toggle X-ray mode in the viewport to pick the edges. Once you've selected your edges, go to Modify, Convert, Polygon Edges to Curve. Enable grid snapping to move the curve under the first controller. Use the Bezier Curve tool to create an arrowhead. This will help identify the direction in which the controller is facing. Select the two curves we want to convert to a new controller and run the shelf script. With our new controller selected, press the Insert key to align its pivot to the first controller's Y-axis. While we're at it, let's move the dish controller's pivot down. Press Insert to stop editing the pivot. In the channel box, lock all the translation channels, as well as Rotate X and Rotate Z. In the outliner, click and hold the middle mouse button to nest the first controller under the second one. Rename the parent controller to Y-Pivot Controller. And rename the child controller to Dish Group Controller. Finally, in a new editor tab, make the following call to connect ATTR to connect the corresponding Rotate Y attributes. With these controls, we now have an easier way to pose and animate our model. We also have a convenient shelf script which we can use to create new controllers.